Looks like somebody hasn't been staying in shape, hmm?
What are you talking about? I'm fine.
Uh-huh. Let's put that to the test, shall we?
No!
Let's see. Your resting heart rate is abnormally high, and your VO2 max is actually much lower than it should be. In conclusion, your endurance sucks. Can you help me improve?
Sure, I'm here to help.
Hey everyone, I'm Luna and you're watching Quick Tips Episode 6. Today we're going to be going back to the topic of SSDs, but in a different light than what you're probably used to. Let's get started! So we've talked about SSDs enough for you to know that one of the primary indicators of performance is read and write speed. But that's not all there is to it. You see, people usually get so caught up in trying to get the fastest SSD possible that they often overlook another very important indicator, endurance. Let's say you're an athlete. In order to take the most of your athletic ability, you need to have not just the explosive power, but also the endurance in order to help you maintain a high level performance over a long period of time. Now, this is the same for SSDs, meaning that a truly high quality SSD won't just have fast read and write speeds, but also the endurance to provide you with more than enough reliability and durability. To measure endurance, we're gonna be looking at a few key metrics: PE, TBW, and MTBF. PE, which is used to refer to program erase cycles, is when data is written to an SSD, erased, and then rewritten. Since each PE cycle causes a tiny amount of damage to the device that accumulates over time, the more PE cycles your SSD is able to run, the higher its degree of endurance. Next, we have TBW, which stands for terabytes written. This one is pretty straightforward in that it refers to the total amount of data your device is capable of writing over its lifespan. So if an SSD has a TBW of 1800 terabytes, this means that you'd be able to write a total cumulative amount of 1800 terabytes over the SSD's entire history of use, after which the SSD will begin nearing the end of its life and won't function as smoothly. Simply put, the higher your SSD's TBW, the longer its lifespan will be. Lastly, we have MTBF, which stands for mean time before failures. Now, this one can get a little bit tricky. Instead of calculating the amount of time that an SSD has in its expected lifetime, it refers to the failure rate of a drive. Regardless, you can still take MTBF as an indicator for how long an SSD will last. So, if your SSD has a higher MTBF, it'll also have a longer lifespan. Now, something you should keep in mind when it comes to your SSD storage space is that just because you have a lot of it doesn't mean you should use all of it. A general rule of thumb is to stay below the 70% threshold. Once you get above the 70% mark, you will start noticing a decline in performance. Another point to take into consideration when purchasing your SSD is that the speed of your device typically correlates with its storage capacity, meaning the higher the capacity, the higher the speed. In order to understand SSD speed, it's important to know the difference between the highest continuous read and write speed and 4K IOPS, which stands for Input Output Operations Per Second. Depending on what your needs are, you may not need super high speeds, and a comparatively lower transfer rate may very well be enough. If you're a gamer or content creator doing design or video editing, then you'll probably want to opt for the highest continuous read and write speed. However, if you're using your SSD for office use or normal everyday tasks, simply having 4K IOPS would get the job done. So now that you know some of the other key indicators for your SSD's performance other than speed, how do you actually go about finding out this information? Well, good thing there are a number of health check tools that you can use to keep track of your SSD status. Now, most companies do have their own tool to gauge an SSD's level of performance, including speed and endurance. The first one is the ADATA SSD Toolbox, which has everything you need to obtain your disk information and also easily change your settings. The ADATA SSD Toolbox comes with some extremely useful functions, such as acquiring drive information, including capacity, drive health, and the lifespan of a drive, running diagnostics on the free space or use space of a selected drive, various SSD utility tools, system optimization, which optimizes the settings of your SSD, and displaying current system information. Another tool worth mentioning is Crystal Disk Info, which is a great utility software for your SSD. In a nutshell, Crystal Disc Info monitors drive health, displays basic drive information, and also monitors disk temperature. If your device is in need of a storage upgrade, you can actually upgrade not only your PC, but also your console if you have a PS4 or Xbox. After you upgrade your PC's SSD, you can even use your old hard drive as an external hard drive. Now, before we wrap things up, I have just one question for you. How do you think your SSD would do in a test of endurance? If you're not sure, just go to the link in the description below to download the SSD Toolbox and run a quick test on your SSD. Then post your results in the comments below. And that's all for this episode of Quick Tips. If you like this video, please give us a like and subscribe. And if you have any tech questions, just leave us a comment to let us know. Thanks for watching. I'm Luna. We'll see you next time.